please welcome Jordan, the Notorious Big Nasty.
This next bout is
three two-minute rounds in the 185-pound division. Introducing your first warrior, fighting out of the blue corner. This man's a mixed martial artist with a record of one win and no losses. He stands 5 feet, 10 inches tall and weighs already 178.8 pounds. Representing Coastal Combat, give it up for Bill Wilson. And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man's a mixed martial artist with a record of 2 wins and 2 losses. He stands 5 feet, 10 inches tall and weighs already 185 pounds. Representing the arena, give it up for Jordan, the Notorious Big Nasty Donais. Your referee is
ladies and gentlemen, we just got news. We are getting instant replay. What did I say earlier, Danny? Ask and ye shall receive.
Shall receive, and that's exactly
what happened. Close mouth, don't get fed. The squeaky wheel gets the grease.
All right. Jordan Donais and Bill Wilson. Bill Wilson's in the blue trunks. Jordan Donais in the Valley Tudo shorts.
I remember Donais from last time.
Yeah, Donais.
Dude is a powerhouse.
Yeah, he's a big, solid puncher.
Last time, fatigue set in on him in the later rounds. I wonder if he worked on that this time.
Donais doing a good job with level changes.
Goes
straight in for
wrestler.
That takedown. Look at his face, just straight in the sternum. No room for a guillotine. Straight face in the chest. Solid wrestling
guy.
This guy
looks like he grew up on the farm next to Matt
Hughes. Yeah, just tossing hay bales for sure.
Jordan Donais. And you can just look at his body and the way he walks and say, wrestler. In the cauliflower ears, of course. Dead giveaway. And if you're watching at home and you're at the bar, do not start anything with somebody with cauliflower ears.
Yeah, when someone with cauliflower ear sees somebody else with cauliflower ear, you just give each other a little subtle head nod and keep moving about your business.
And usually big old traps and neck go with those cauliflower ears.
Now we see.
But actually, I'm looking at Donais' ears. They're not that bad for wrestlers. Really pretty ears he has, I must say.
Yeah, those are gorgeous ears.
Don't worry, he's still an amateur. By the time he turns pro, he'll probably have some.
So here we go. Donais looking like he's looking for something off the cage. And I got to say,
he's underhook knee tap. He's going for the Jito.
William Wilson's doing a great job of defending and just staying comfortable. But he needs to try to reverse the position. He needs to try to get out of there.
Yep, this round is winding down. And so far,
Donais is tearing away at that right leg of Wilson.
I hate to say it, but Donais won this round by cage control. Which, 100%. In my opinion, you shouldn't be rewarded for that. You should be penalized. Bring back the yellow cards, but don't take 10% of the purse. Oh, my God, they're amateurs. They don't have a purse.
Well, you know what? You know, 100%, I'd give that fight to Donais. And like you said, it's pure cage control. I mean, I want to see William. I want to see what he does. I don't know if he's a striker, if he's a wrestler, if he's a jiu-jitsu guy.
Exactly, we know nothing about him. And ladies and gentlemen, here in America, in a cage, Donais was winning this round, right? In Japan, in a ring, in Pride, Wilson wins the round and Donais gets a yellow card. Isn't that bizarre?
Wow, that's pretty crazy.
But Pride has been dissolved by the UFC. Thanks a lot. I loved Pride. And you know what? I buried him, Danny. I'm the one who helped bury him.
With your incredible fight with that first tough, is that what you're talking about?
Imagine the guilt I carry with me, Danny. I killed Pride. I killed
K1.
I'm a monster.
You know, you're so selfish for you to just care about your career only.
No. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, everybody.
And here we go, Donais closing in again on. Oh, and Wilson throws solid shots on Donais.
Let's see what Wilson's got. This is his chance. You got to get off, buddy. Can't spend the round on the cage.
Yeah, and well, you know what? Donais doing. Oh, and Wilson lands solid body shot.
Switch kick. That's my favorite. Switch kick to the
Donais,
body.
Straight to wrestling, like yes. We can expect.
And let's see.
And there we go. He gets the takedown there. Donais gets the takedown. Wilson has his head, but it's not deep at all.
Yeah, Wilson's got to learn. You'll only have one round left. When you're on the round, when you're on the cage, you're going to go on the ground. All right? Yeah. Stay off the cage. It's fire. Pretend it's fire. And you'll burn yourself on the cage.
So we have Jordan Donais on top.
Just, typical, hey, ladies and gentlemen, we've had 7 knockouts and submissions so far. So, relax.
They were all within before the 3rd round.
This fight will be over in 3 minutes. And so far, Jordan doing a lot of cage control and takedown work. I mean, this is pretty much a wrestling match for him. He's treating this as a wrestling match.
100%. I mean, even when he had him on the ground, he didn't posture up for ground and pound.
I mean,
he looks like he just wants to wrestle today.
Very important damage, but he's still winning the rounds. If this fight were closer, though, the guy did a little more damage, might stake it out. But Bill Wilson absolutely is really giving us maybe, what, one landed punch?
Yeah, yep. he had a good like combo thrown and a leg kick or a body shot thrown.
Yeah, the switch kick to the body, a couple punches look good.
But just too little, man. And, he might get choked. Had an arm choke there. That was a nice setup. Sneaky and strong guys could finish that move. And trust me, Donais is strong enough to finish that head and arm choke.
You know, a lot of times when you have a fight like this, you can already kind of know what to expect. I'll tell you right now, we're going to come out and Donais is going to come in with that takedown again. Oh, no, are we going to get an instant replay? It looked like almost. Maybe
ladies and gentlemen, did I tell you I am psychic? The 3rd round, this is what's going to happen. Donais is going to come out, take Bill Wilson down, go into the mount, throw a couple punches, and then try to finish him with a head and arm choke. But you know what, Danny? In fighting, if you find something that works, stick to it.
100%.
Just like that beautiful knockout we saw earlier that was your candidate for knockout of the night.
Jonathan Molina.
Molina with that lead right hook. His first punch of the fight he landed. And that's eventually demise.
And you see that mindset in every sport. In football, you run the ball until it doesn't work anymore. You see that all the time.
Correct a mundo.
There you go. They come out and touch gloves. This is the first fight of the night to make it to the 3rd round.
I wonder if Jordan's going to do a little striking now that he's really like making someone wrestle. Carry your weight like that takes their punching power away. A good time low kick there.
Solid low kick by Donais. Donais just moving forward.
See, now Donais is like, I got 2 rounds in the bucket. I'll try throwing a few strikes before the takedown.
He's gonna turn him the other way.
Yeah. He's been finishing on the cage easily, so I believe he's gonna finish this takedown. Going with the old Chris Lieben foot stomps. You know what? I don't think I've ever foot stomped anyone. Maybe ever? Once. Maybe once, yeah.
Not even in training? Like, let me just try it out?
In training, it's rude. Those are your friends.
Yeah, but, you know, sometimes they're
not. When someone has said to me in training, I'm like, what the hell are you doing, dude? And here we are, under a minute left, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to get our first decision of the night here at Epic Fighting.
You called it. You said it was going to be a lot, so that must mean next couple fights will be straight decisions, Stephan.
Oh, no, just this one. We're going to be back to knockouts and submissions.
And there we go. Those of you watching at home, maybe you don't really understand what's going on. I know it looks a little bit boring, but it does take some technique to control somebody on the cage like this.
It's not too exciting, but Bill Wilson, after this fight,
needs to go home and work on staying off the cage. Really, watch Machida fight. He gets on the cage and circles.
I mean,
I tell people, pretend the cage is hot and it's going to burn you.
You know, this is, in my opinion, it's pretty much Donais' fight at this point. Yeah. He's been dominating all 3 rounds and mostly
won every round.
With just cage control. That's
absolutely.
He won this fight with cage control.
Yes, here we go. We have one boring decision out of eight fights. That's not bad, ladies and gentlemen. Not bad at all.
So Jordan Donais came into this fight 2-2, and William Wilson came into this fight 1-0.
That's right. He's gonna leave 1-1.
1-1. And you know what? I mean, you saw that inexperience in Wilson here today. Seeing that, he needs to work on his cage work. He needs to work on his wrestling defense.
That's right.
He can't get taken down. You can work on sprawling all day, but as soon as you get put up against the cage, there's not really much sprawling you can do. So you need to work on circling out and really just trying to keep it up on the feet.
Thank you, Samantha.
Absolutely, man. Like, you learn more from your losses.
You sure do, Danny.
As always, you see the sportsmanship of the fighters inside of the cage. And sure enough, we should see a decision for Donais, in my opinion, and I think Stephan Bonnar feels the same way.
Here we are with Chris Lieben to raise the hand of the victor. So I thought, did you guys fake me out again?
No, Chris Lieben was the official in that one.
No, yeah. All right, I thought they were ready for the announcement. I guess not. So you know what that means, ladies and gentlemen. We get to keep talking.
That's right. I tell you what, that's something that I love to do.
You know, everyone asks me that. Like, oh, you love calling fights so much. Yes, I do. I really do.
Yeah, why not? Are you
just a big loudmouth? Do you just like to hear yourself talk?
Well, you know what? Even when I'm watching fights at home, I do this in my living
room.
Me
too.
No matter what.
Me too. Yes. I know they can't hear me. I coach people too from the TV. Yeah.
So you know what? This looks like this was Jordan Donais. I don't know why, but it's like Harvey's getting a belt ready. I don't know if this was a title fight or what the case is.
Yes!
Maybe the next fight is a title fight.
Maybe
that's what it is.
We're having another technical difficulty.
Another one? No, say it ain't so, Stephan.
Hey, you never know. We had one tonight. Usually every promotion has at least one in it.
Always.
You know?
Always.
So we had a little mic. The mic went cold.
Yeah.
So we had that. But we are getting replay, and here we are with the announcement.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Another incredible epic fight. This one goes the judges' scorecards after three rounds. Your first judge scores about 29-28. Your next judge scores about 30-27, and your last judge scores at 30-27 for your winner. Out of the red corner, Jordan the Big Nasty, Donais.
The Big Nasty with the big W.
I'd say that's a fitting name for him.
That's a cool nickname.
That is. But if you look at him, and I told you, that's Big Nasty.
Yeah, the
if
Big
I said,
Nasty.
Hey, go talk to Big Nasty.
And you know who he reminds me of a little? His build and everything, fighting style? Filthy Tom Lawler. You got Filth the...